what was looked at was sperm DNA in men that were obese, mm-hmm. And men that were non-obese, so healthy men. And there was a variety, like over 500 genes were changed in terms of like how their expression were, right? So their epigenetics were changed. And a lot of these genes had to do with metabolism. They had to do with cognitive function. Mm-hmm. These men underwent bariatric surgery. So these were obese, morbidly obese men. They underwent bariatric surgery, mm-hmm. and their sperm DNA was measured pretty close after, and then like a year later. Ooh. And the epigenetics mm-hmm. switched back to closer to what the lean men looked like. So it was really
amazing.
A very interesting kind of pilot study indicating there definitely seems to be a causal, like, obesity is changing the, a lot of, the way these genes are in sperm DNA, yeah. Which is what you're passing on.
Oh my God.
And there's
it's
been
huge.
Tons of studies yeah. showing, male yeah. mice that are obese have, offspring, like, female offspring that are, get type 1 diabetes because they get like some autoimmune thing or, mm-hmm. so there's been lots of animal studies.
Yes.
Of course, you can only
yeah.
translate so much of that. So yeah. I felt like that human study was really, a good pilot study to really kind of show, look, this is happening in humans, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. and certainly make people think men aren't off the hook either,
yeah.
And that's
right.
oftentimes are,
yeah.
I think that I'm not sure a lot of men are aware of the fact that,
yeah.
that their lifestyle actually does matter.
Right. They're becoming more important than we think.
Right.